those who, after peace was established in Europe, continued to be involved in the conflict in Asia and the Pacific. The breadth of our commemoration is also greater than this. Today we also remember the part played by all the people of our nations and Commonwealth who lived through that period of war. For those at home and abroad with arms and with action, they shared the conviction that oppression and tyranny must not prevail.
So as we gather, we will affirm our commitment to ensuring the welfare and dignity of those of our number who are of the wartime generation. We shall acknowledge with gratitude the courage of men, women and children who, despite all the hardships and calamities of war, kept national and international hope alive. Inspired by the remembrance of those who made the ultimate sacrifice, let us pray for the coming of God's reign among us, as Jesus himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
God, our Father, in the dying and rising of your Son, Jesus Christ, you have brought life and salvation out of cruelty and death. We mark victory in Japan in gratitude for the courage of the Allied forces who suffered for freedom in the Far East campaign, and in sorrow for all that hinders the coming of your kingdom of peace. Give us wisdom to learn from the bitter memories of war, and hearts that long for the unity of all nations. We ask all this in the name of Jesus, in whom there is no east or west, no north or south, but one fellowship of love across the whole earth.
Victory over Japan Day, said this. Japan has surrendered, so let us join in thanking Almighty God that war has ended throughout the world, and that in every country, men may now turn their industry, skill, and science to repairing its frightful devastation and to building prosperity and happiness. Our sense of deliverance is overpowering. And with it all, we have a right to feel that we have done our duty. Our hearts are full to overflowing, as are your own. Yet there is not one of us who has experienced this terrible war who does not realize that we shall feel its inevitable consequences long after we have all forgotten our rejoicings of today. We have spent freely of all that we had. Now we shall have to work hard to restore what has been lost and to establish peace on the unshakable foundations, not alone of material strength, but also of moral authority. Then indeed the curse of war may be lifted from the world, and states and peoples, great and small, may dwell together through long periods of tranquility in brighter and better days than we ourselves have known. We have our part to play in restoring the shattered fabric of civilization. It is a proud and difficult part. It is to this great task that I call you now. and I know that I shall not call in vain.
Over 40 million people died during the Second World War, which was not only the bloodiest conflict, but also the largest war in history, in which over 580,000 British and Commonwealth service personnel were killed. VGA Day celebrated the final coming of peace with the commemoration of all those who fought and lost their lives. Around 52,000 Britons died, including 12,000 prisoners of war. Let us now remember all victims of the war. Calling before God all those who died or injured and those who fought for peace. Remember, O Lord, the fallen in battle, the tortured and the maimed, and the innocents who died. Remember your people who cry to you in their grief and sorrow. Remember your power to heal and save, and all for your tender mercy's sake.
is taken from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 2, beginning to read at the second verse. In the days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest mountain, and shall be raised above the hills. All the nations shall stream to it. Many peoples shall come and say, "Come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, that we may walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth instruction, and the word of the Lord of Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations, and shall arbitrate for the many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nations shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall we learn war anymore. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord." Here endeth the reading.
Children, the same Heavenly Father. Whatever our age, whatever our nation or heritage. Some amongst us have lived through the Second World War, and others are of a younger generation. But we all have a responsibility under God to care for one another. As members of the wider community, I invite you to make your own commitment to the people of the wartime generation and to the legacy of peace for which they made many sacrifices. Will you honour all who bore the pains and adversities of war? By the help of God, we will. Will you remember the causes for which they endured adversity, and for which many fought and died, by promoting peace, justice, and harmony among all people? Will you always acknowledge how precious are the gifts which God has entrusted to us, and exercise the freedoms and opportunities you have with gratitude and humility? By the help of God, we will. May Almighty God, who has given us the will to undertake all these things, give us also the strength to perform them. Amen. Amen.
Lord, hear us.
gift of peace. And let us pray for all who now live amidst conflict and for those who live in fear of violence or oppression. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us give thanks for the reconciliation that has been established between nations once supposed in war, for the people of all nations and their leaders, that those divisions that remain may be healed. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us give thanks for all who offer care and support to the people of the wartime generation, whether as individuals or through the work of statutory or voluntary bodies, that they may have wisdom, vision, and compassion in all they do. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Finally, let us pray for all those who have and continue to be affected by the terrible and deadly effects of COVID-19, and that the world may fight to defeat this and every virus that seeks to destroy humanity. Lord, hear us.
Let us remember to fore God all who have died as a result of war, oppression, and tyranny. They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them.
Thank you.
When you go home, tell of them of us the same. For your tomorrow, we gave our today.
And we that are left to grow old with the years, remembering the heartache, the pain and the tears, hoping and praying that never again man will sing such sorrow and shame. The price that was paid we will always remember, every day, every month, not just in November.
We will continue to remember that. cry for peace, composed for this 75th anniversary of the end of the Second World War and VJ Day. Victory in Europe was on the 8th day of May. Now it's August 15th, so what of this day? Japan's now surrendered and told to lay down its arms. Go back to your factories, offices, and farms. But in Singapore, Thailand, and Burma no less, our forgotten army still had to clear up the mess. We mustn't forget the way in the Far East, or the lives which were lost before the battles were ceased. Three quarters of a century have passed since those days, and life has moved on in so many ways. So August 15th became a day of celebration as Japan agreed to the Potsdam Declaration. And on September 2nd, at last it was done. The World War was over, the battles been won. VJ Day is a day to be cherished, when we remember all those who have perished. Stand proudly, my country, stand proudly with Britain. Dwell on this cry, so proudly written. This kingdom never gave up, and it must never forget. God save the Queen.
Go forth into the world as pilgrims of God, upheld by the hands of Him who created you. Go forth to discover new life in Christ, Son of the living God, who died for you. Go in the strength of the Holy Spirit, whose indwelling power will renew you and fill you with joy and hope. Go in the name of the Holy Trinity, to light lamps of justice and peace with the oil of righteousness. Amen.